We are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome here in New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the San Francisco 49ers. Here's a punter, Thomas Morstead, to get this one started. And we are underway from the Superdome.
Taken in the end zone. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
Second and 11.
Brings up second.
Ball at the 24 at a second and 11. Here's Jackson to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 11 yards there. First down. Little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, 49ers. Brandon Ayuk with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Niners have taken the early lead.
Robbie Gould.
Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions. And whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play. Go for the big one, and they got it done.
Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This will make it into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Throwing on first down is Breeze. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And these guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. And they could not ask for a worse start. You give up a touchdown on the game's opening drive, and then you turn right around and throw the interception on your very first play.
And this is where the coaching staff has to earn its money, because they've got to calm these guys down a little bit. Just as you noted, a horrendous start both sides of the ball. But now the defense, which gave up an opening drive touchdown, they've got to go out there now and start playing like the team they want to be.
15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the gun, Jackson. And this is incomplete. Deebo Samuel was the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Jackson now on second and 10. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco.
George Kittle.
George Kittle. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the 49ers add on to their lead. Not even 2 minutes into this football game, already we've had two scores.
You know how much I like to read about teams of old, right? The teams of yesteryear. There were some teams that were known as the point-a-minute teams. Well, obviously in a 60-minute game, that's 60-plus points. But two touchdowns? in the first 2 minutes, my calculator doesn't operate that well.
And now on the other side, they better wake up. They haven't even gotten off the bus yet. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
Kamara, the ball carrier.
In on the stop, it was Tre'Varius Moore.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second.
From the 27, Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
The 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Latavius Murray. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Give them 18 there, and the Saints have a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Looking here for Smith downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Tre'Quan Smith, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Jimmy Ward there.
The scoreboard tells the story for him, a little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Thomas, the intended target, and now it's third down.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Now Breeze on third down. Flush to his right. It's caught, Smith. And they will get this across midfield, but still well short of the first as he's dropped at the 46.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
35 yards that time on the punt, and the 49ers will take over deep in their own territory. So well done there, and these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do, and now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies, and that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football, they're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. On the slant, able to find Ayuk. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
A gain of 22 yards.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
First down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Geis with the carry on second down. Able to push forward for about four down to the 37.
The ball carrier.
Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep him to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
And man is Pettis. It's complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 15-yard line. Give them 22 there on the third down conversion. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. On first down, this is Geis. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Brandon, I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the run.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Debo Samuel with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. Boy, these guys are off to the races, Charles. 20-0 already, extra point pending.
Yeah, you always hear that term. They just boat race someone. Heck, it's car race, motorcycle race, plane race, whatever you want. Right now, they are sprinting past them.
Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And things haven't started so well for this side. Two drives, two punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done. Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
35-yard line.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Kamara. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Greenlaw on the tackle. No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 35-yard
line. 21-0, our score after one.
With the score, Niners 21, Saints nothing.
Here's second and 10. Throwing now is Breeze. This one into the hands of Burton. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. It's a gain of 35.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Shotgun now for Breeze. And this is caught through the ground. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 14. 11 yards there, first down.
14-yard line.
That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Into the red zone, it's Breeze. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. 7 yards left for second down. Ball at the 10.
From the gun, it's Breeze. Oh, the intercepted. Picked up by the first runner, Jimmy Moore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
First and 10.
Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost him.
And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. Cameron Jordan wreaking havoc with a sack.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Pass complete to his receiver, Pettis. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Throwing is Jackson. Off to Geis on the screen. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Scram for the football, and he's going to come down with it.
He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Jackson from the shotgun. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Off the play fake, here's Jackson. It's running for Ayuk, but it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Jackson with a pick. And they finally put an end to this return. But now the boys all the way down on the 37.
Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said, third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
Up incomplete.
As we've seen, their first two drives didn't yield anything points-wise. Certainly feels like they think to themselves, it's time to open this thing up, taking the big shot downfield.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10. Breeze going to throw. And Breeze is intercepted for the 3rd time. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell 3 times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Back to the ground on first. It's Geis. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
He was brought down.
Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Only needing 2 yards on 2nd down. Jackson. And that is incomplete. Force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. They'll try and get it with Geis. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're... And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown.
Touchdown, San Francisco.
Darius Geis with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now.
Score, Niners 28, Saints nothing.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
Their own 21-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
2nd and 5.
Second and 5 now. Breeze. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. A gain of 13. It's a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now Breeze. And brought in by the tight end Cook. That catch good for only a couple.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down.
They run from the shotgun.
Murray.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47.
Latavius Murray, the ball carrier.
And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
It takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
Sets up fourth down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
First and 10.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Jackson now down around his goal line. Looking to complete it to Patterson. He's got him. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. He got 29 yards that time.
29 yards. And the 49er first down.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. This is caught inside the 15. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
First down, San Francisco.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
For George Kittle, incomplete. It's now second and 10.
No move for the field goal unit. They're going to go here with 5 seconds left. Final play of the half here, it's Jackson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And he will be brought down as time is now running on this first half of action. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number 3. Now this will make it into the end zone, and we will not see a run back here from Harris. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
Brings up third down and 6.
From the gun on third down, Breeze. And he finds Carr. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
First and down.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
This will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
From the 41, Breeze. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. They'll run here. It's Murray. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down in a few inches. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Escaping the pressure right. This pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 31, and the return stops at the 39-yard line. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
And now the drive starts with a completion out to the right. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
To George Kittle.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Lines up and lets it go for Samuel. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 19-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Jared Cook, his Pro Bowl tight end, was the target. Third down here.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
And now here's another interception. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. Yet another interception.
question, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
4-yard loss on the play.
Now from the 7, here's 2nd and goal.
At the 7-yard line.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Touchdown, 49ers!
The keeper. Touchdown.
They've already been on record as saying, hey, if our rookie quarterback's going to tuck it and run on a scramble, we kind of hold our breath. Well, that was a maybe no, yes, as he's able to get into the end zone.
Are you saying he's got to learn where the line is about whether you keep your eyes downfield and try and find a receiver or you tuck it and go? And I think there's going to be some growing pains with that. I think in this case, he made the right decision.
And we know he's got the speed. He showed it there. And they will watch this one land in the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. Fighting through, he's got space. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Alvin Kamara hit the NFL with a bang, had double-digit touchdowns in his first 2 seasons. Now, production fell off a little bit last year. Just 6 times did he find the end zone. But his ability to run it and catch it out of the backfield makes him hard to cover. Look for a bounce-back season in 2020.
Number stop made by Fred Warner, who was the Niners' leading tackler during their run to the Super Bowl last year.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got you to pin their ears back and get after him now.
And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Here's Breeze to throw. This game. Nearly another pick. Now 4th down.
It's now 4th down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Still just the 3rd quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. Here we go with Kamara. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. Alvin Kamara unable to push past that yellow line. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That catch good for only a couple.
At the 41-yard line.
2nd and 8 coming up. Now Jackson. Open man is Samuel, complete.
Jackson.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And Jackson throwing once more. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. Back now here live in New Orleans. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. And good running, going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 30. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
It's a gain of 8.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
And
a gain of 10 and a 49er first down. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people have pointed out to me, it's a video game.
And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Darius Geis with his 13th touchdown of the year and second of the game as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Niners 42, Saints nothing. Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On the ground, this is Kamara. Get it up past the 45. 10 yards, good for his Saints first down. A couple of very nice carries to start this drive out.
Yeah, two first downs. And how about that second one? What a nice run on that particular play. I'm telling you, they're going to start to think that this game is easy if they continue to rip off yardage like this.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield after a gain of about 4.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz it? Do I need to pressure it? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Breeze's throw on target to Cook, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 10 yards, good for a Saints first down.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he's across for the touchdown. Two-yard, he is getting for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero.
Good.
Are you, you're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle.
Fielded in the end zone.
And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And right about now, heck, they might be wishing they did not have a bye week coming up next week. The Bears are going to go into that week off in high spirits as they've got this one well in hand. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
There's a beautiful throw there, and he's been sensational the entire game, moving it around, spreading it, hitting the right guys. And look, under normal situations, partner, I would expect him to come out of the game now. They've got it in hand. But you and I have been around this league a long time, and every time we ask head coaches about it, hey, why don't you take your quarterback out when the game's in hand? They just kind of give us that look like that's what he's paid to do. So it's a very unusual situation. I'd want him out. They tend to leave him in.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. They'll try and burn some clock with Geis. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
The tackle made by DeMario Davis.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And his pass is intercepted from the 14 to Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5 at the 37-yard line.
Ready. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. Complete. Smith has it. Taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. 27 yards there. First down. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2.
Yards on the pickup.
He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there. Of course you're going to give it to him.
Today's final score, Niners.
A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory, and
the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the 49ers, they continue to put themselves in position for a first-round bye as they move to 8-2. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for New Orleans, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Atlanta Falcons come to town. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.